nice to see you again. We met briefly at the Kennedy Center on at the awards. You actually bring your mom to a lot of fun places.
Oh, man, she's been on tour more than most rock moms I know. She's perfectly comfortable on the road, though. You know, I give her a laminate and play a gig and come back to the dressing room and she's having a beer with Green Day, you know.
She knows. But in this case, you brought him because you have a new book called From Cradle to Stage, Stories from the Mothers Who Rocked and Raised Rock Stars. Right there. Okay. So it's your story of raising this man over here and talking to other mothers who raise rock stars.
Yes.
Now, like any good mother, you brought an embarrassing photograph to start off here. There is. Okay. At what point did it occur to you that he might be a rock star? This was going to be his life.
Well, I didn't know he was going to be a rock star. Mm-hmm. I knew he was going to be a musician. I knew really early he was going to be an entertainer. I have the feeling that some of you have it in your blood somewhere that you just start out being goofy. Am I? Yeah.
Yeah, it beats hard work.
And silly and making people laugh.
Uh-huh.
And that's the way he was.
It seemed like that might have been your focus, Dave, because your mother also brought along one of your report cards I'd like to share. Here, this is an actual report card from sixth grade, I believe. Would it be 80, 81?
That was a tough one. That was
okay,
a tough year.
Okay, let's listen to this here. Was a tough year here. Let's see. Respects authority. Needs improvement. Is courteous, needs improvement, accepts responsibility, unsatisfactory, exercises self-control, needs improvement, exerts effort, unsatisfactory, begins and completes work on time, unsatisfactory, uses time wisely, works neatly, works accurately.
How long is this segment?
Dave, we have to talk about this.
You know, I gotta be honest, I was kicking ass up until first grade, and then it was all downhill from there.
And at 17, you tell your mom what?
Well, I started playing music when I was maybe 9 or 10 years old, and I just kind of took to it. Once I started playing it, I couldn't really think of much else. I was just focused on playing music, and I got the bug. And so all of my focus and energy went to just playing. And so kind of everything else went out the window. And you know, my mother, having been a public school teacher for 35 years, I think she understood that some kids don't necessarily thrive in that fluorescent-lit public school system. Mm-hmm. It might be able to work outside of it a little more. And so I had the opportunity to go start traveling Europe and the world when I was 17 or 18, playing music. And my mother, because she had seen generations of kids who might have been really bright kids struggle within that system, she sort of looked at me and said, okay.
It's a great idea.
Go.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You said go?